Why nesting grounds won't be used as much unless you are in a big, really big and differentiated herd or pack, because you are very vulnerable to other players. It's easy to see, I mean, at least in my opinion, it is to foresee situations where people will grow actually Dryozoros or might grow even Stegos, although Stegos will be very annoying, and they will go just after your nest, in nesting grounds. You know where to go, and you start biting at these nests. Bite force of Dryozoros now has been improved at the moment in the stress test server, at least has been improved with a plus 10 points of damage. Now I deal 20 points of damage, which is a huge deal, these 20 points of damage. I can disrupt a nest that might be here with a couple of bites less than I would have required if my bite force were to be 10, for example. Same thing goes with Pteranodon, that now bite force of Pteranodon is not 15, but 25. Or imagine there is a Stegosaurus. Now, if you do have Stegosaurus around that is going after your nest, and it is just two, three players that are taking care of such nests in a nesting ground like this one, well, you have to choose another spot. Not a spot where you have a faster incubation period, not a spot where your hatchlings will grow faster, or where the temperature decay is slower, but you have to choose a safer spot, because plenty of people, once they grow at 100%, or plenty of people that are just hungry with their carnivore, or they just or they are just bored. I'm taking into account Stegosaurus players. You are just bored, you don't know what to do. So you go after people that are nesting in nesting grounds. So if you are looking forward to nest, you won't be nesting in nesting grounds unless you are in a truly big and variegated pack herd, like many members, many players with different playables, where each playable perk will complement another playable flow. Making an example, Pakis with Karnos, for example, or another example, Thanos with Pakis. We have seen, you above all have seen by the dam, huge clusters of Thanos players playing along with Paki players. That's the most common herd that we have nowadays. It's very rare to find a pack with Yutas and Karnos all together, but it is still possible, but very rare. So unless you are in such a big and variegated group, you won't be safe nesting in nesting grounds. Your nest will very easily be disrupted by an alpha an hour growth dinosaur. With a perfect diet, Dryozoros will grow in roughly, if I mistake not, in roughly half an hour with a perfect diet, virtually speaking, or will be disrupted by a Pteranodon once both parents are not close the nest, are not close enough to the nest, or parents decide not to damage such player, that is, such aggressive player, because such player is over the nest. Let's say the nest is here, where this little rock is. I am biting the nest as a Dryozoros, and I keep biting it. The Notosaurus around, or the Stegosaurus around, won't actually be tail whipping me or tail slamming me, because I am on their nest. If they use tail slam, if they use any of their attacks, powerful attacks, they may destroy their own nests. So, I mean, I wouldn't destroy my nest, generally speaking, unless I think, alright, it's time to move somewhere else safer. I won't have the same benefits that I find in a nesting grounds, but at least we are gonna be safer. Probably plenty of people will decide to nest in a forest or by any other secluded place, like outside of hotspots or outside of nesting grounds, which might become very easily the future hotspots or probably not the hot spots, but the mild hot spots. I don't know if you get that. Sorry. But yeah, kinda. Well, that's all for today. It was Gabriele. Thank you all so much for watching. Tell me what you think about this, because personally, I wouldn't use nesting grounds unless I am in a big pack, unless I am in a big herd with different types of playables in it, in a huge pack herd, that is. Otherwise, it's not gonna be worthy unless I am, me and the other player are fast enough to grow our hatchlings. Otherwise, it's not gonna be worth it, because you need to be fast if you are a little group to grow them, just to be out of danger as soon as possible, because plenty of people, because of boredom, plenty of people, because of food, they will come to nesting grounds just to have a look. What? Or just to do something. I mean, you are a Dryosaurus, you are bored, it's very hard for you to get into a skirmish successfully. You cannot do much damage because you are a little one. Yes, you are a juvenile killer, as a Dryosaurus, for example, but there is nothing else to do. So you decide to go after nests, and you need to find a nest. And where can you find nests? Here, in nesting grounds, or in these type of areas. So nesting in itself will be actually used successfully, or with less rage quits, that I already see some of you rage quitting. I don't know why, but unfortunately you do. Rage quitting, it's very unhealthy, but all right. Now, you wanna choose forest, secluded places, safest places in order to nest, unless you are in a big group. If you are a small group, you need to be fast making up your nest and inviting other friendly players, and then move on. And if you nest in nesting grounds or in places that are common to nest, you need to take into account that your nest will actually be destroyed, will eventually be destroyed. It happens. Well, that's all for today. This was me and my powerful Dryosaurus. These are just my opinions, mind it. These are just my opinions. Please tell me what you think about nesting, where you should be nesting, and what are the conditions that you have to meet in order to nest successfully. I'm not talking about a perfect diet, I'm not talking about safety, like environment safety, taking into account that the server has 100 players and they might come after your nest because they are getting bored, those players, because they need food, because of many reasons. Well, that's all. For real, thank you all so much for watching. Consider subscribing this channel and let me know what you think about that in the comment section below. Always be polite to each other and have a great day. Bye bye.